In this exercise, we need to verify that the pair A and B with this definition of the addition and this definition of the multiplication is a field. And to do this, we need to show all 9 field axioms. Let's get started with the commutativity of addition, where we need to show that the pair AB plus the pair CD is the same as the pair CD plus the pair AB. After applying the definition of our addition, we get A plus C and B plus D equals C plus A and D plus B. And that's the same because the normal addition is commutative and we can flip C and A and D and B. For the commutativity of the multiplication, we need to show that AB times CD is the same as CD times AB. After applying the definition of the multiplication, we get those two terms. And again, those terms are equal because we can swap out variables through the normal commutativity of the addition and multiplication. We will continue by proving the associativity of the addition, where we have to show that the order of adding 3 elements together doesn't matter. At first, we will refactor the addition for those big parentheses. Then the pair AB remains, and this term will be formed into C plus E and D plus F. And on the right side, we can exactly copy the definition for our addition, which gives us A plus C and B plus D, and the pair EF remains. Now we need to apply the addition one more time to merge those two pairs respectively. And then we can see that both sides of the equation are equal. Proving the associativity of the multiplication is a little bit more tedious because its definition is bigger. But again, we will start by refactoring the terms inside the big parentheses. And if you haven't mismatched any variable names, you will get this term. And the next step is to apply the multiplication one more time. At this point, it's really important that you don't get confused by all those variable names. But we can simplify those terms one more time. Notice that those two additions will turn into a subtraction because of those two negative signs. In the last step, we need to compare both terms and check if they are equal. I will start by comparing the left element of the pairs. Here we have a positive ACE, which is also here. Then we have a negative ADF, which we can also find here. We also have a negative BCF, which is also included here. And a negative BDE, which is also included here. On the right side of the pairs, we have a positive ACF, a positive ADE, a positive BCE, and a negative BDF. And because the order of the addition and subtraction doesn't matter, those two pairs are equal too. With the additive identity, we need to find a pair CD, which doesn't affect the pair AB. So AB plus CD is again AB. After applying the definition of the addition, we have A plus C and B plus D should equal AB. And therefore we know that C and D have to be 0. And with that we have found 0, 0, which is our additive identity. For the multiplicative identity, we do something similar, only that we apply the definition of the multiplication. So we need to find a C and D so that AC minus BD and AD plus BC is the same as AB. So the first element of the pair has to be A and the second element of the pair has to be B. We can remove our B from the left side of the pair by setting D to 0 and we can keep our A by setting C to 1. And on the right side of the pair we can do the same, so we don't want the A, so we set D to 0 and we set C to 1 because we want the B. Therefore we know that our multiplicative identity is the pair 1 and 0. For the additive inverse we need an element that when we add it to AB equates to the additive identity, which is 0, 0. So we have AB plus AB inverse equals 0, 0. For simplicity, I will call AB inverse CD. And after applying the addition, we get A plus C and B plus D should equal 0, 0. Thus, C needs to be minus A and D needs to be minus B, and therefore, AB inverse is negative A and negative B, which is our additive inverse. For the multiplicative inverse, we need to find an AB inverse that, when we multiply it with AB, equates to our multiplicative identity, which is 1, 0. And again, for simplicity, I will call AB inverse CD. After refactoring the multiplication, we get AC minus BD, and AD plus BC should equate to 1 and 0. At this point, we cannot easily recognize when this term equates to 1 and this term equates to 0, and that is why we have to solve those two equations for C and D. I'm not going to solve those two equations for C and D in this video because it would probably take too long, but if you do solve it, you should find that the multiplicative inverse should look like this pair. The last axiom to prove is the distributivity, which states that AB multiplied with CD plus EF is the same as AB times CD plus AB times EF. Usually we also need to prove this statement, but as we have already shown that the multiplication is commutative, we don't need to do this. After applying the addition on the left side and the multiplications on the right side, we get this equation. And after applying this multiplication and this addition, we get this equation. So on the left side we have an AC and on the right side too. Here we have an AE and it's also here. Then we also have a negative BD, which is also here. And there is a negative BF, which is also here. So the first element in those pairs is equal, and we need to do the same for the second pair. And here we have an AD, and positive AF, and positive BC, and a positive BE. And with that we have also shown the last axiom, which is the distributivity. Because all 9 axioms could be proven, we can conclude that our pairs of AB with the addition and multiplication we've defined above is indeed a field.